Onivia, League of Legends highlights, powered by ArcaneBet.com. Bet live on esports.
The Dunker, the Jarvan's picked up for the top lane.
Now, there was one really cool thing about Robo when he was actually playing the J4 was the fact that he was so aware of how the champion works in laning.
Not use his W there.
There is someone coming up the river though to where he just walked towards.
Gonna have to be careful. Fabulous looking for the fight already. Taunt connects as he slides his way out, charges up the uppercut, but Naru's here, smacks him with the baseball bat and picks up first blood in the top lane for Supermassive.
And all it took was the flash, which was definitely the Hurricane.
He hasn't been spotted out here, so Lee Sin is right behind Caitlyn. BRDT caught in the Piltover Peacemaker animation allows Stormar to pick up a kill.
He's completely stuck with his pants down, BRDT. No response there because he's stuck throwing out the Q, so Supermassive
continuing their push top side of the map. Robo is stuck alone to deal with this one. That's Fabulous. He wants a piece of BRTT. He's going to give him some justice himself. BRTT's just running away, but he chucks a couple of punches into his face. It takes him down one-on-one.
Your cupcakes do nothing, VRTT.
He gets the heck out of there.
Meanwhile, they're definitely looking at the Baron. It's at half health.
Well, here comes the teleport. Robo's trying to get in. Even if he does, it's still a 4-on-4. With them trying to get into the back lines. Will he get the smite? It's taken away by Snowmarch. Robo wanted to try and steal that one, but Supermassive get the major objective.
Teleport
and
in.
They've got Echo coming into the back lines. Blastco gets them back to safety, but Robo does get taken down. Jude is trying to get the heck out of Dodge as well, as Supermassive increase their gold lead.
They've already got the Galio bottom side. That's where they're going to start this one off. Is actually, Red Cannons are in.
Red Cannons want to go for a fight, but here comes Galio with a big three-man knocker. BRTT is locked out as well. Robo, who started the fight, has already got the heck out of there as Red Cannons lose their AD carry.
And nothing's going to stop the Galio from killing Caitlyn at this stage. That's just where we're at.
As you mentioned, Caitlyn's just going to stay behind for so long, and they're going in again. Supermassive, they're not afraid of no one. Stormarch deep into the back lines, kicks Robo back of all people. Doesn't matter because Supermassive
goes in.
Big taunt onto three people with Naru diving into the back line as well. BRTT is going to get taken down. Robo's trying to run for the hills. Fabulous is a giant gargoyle who is wreaking havoc into the back lines. And Supermassive are going to try and push for the win here.
Definitely looks like they're going to push for it. There's three members alive, but I don't think they have enough to prevent this.
Here they go. Icon's not quite in sync, but they're happy because the Turkish lineup have been able to pick up a win here against Red Cannon to go 3-0 in Group A, day one of MSI play-ins.
And after a victory like that, it's safe to say that the Turkish side are your favorites in Group A. They are the number one team, and they just proved it convincingly against the opponents that you might have expected to be a bit closer.
I mean, especially when that was a near-perfect game. All dragons taken away, all barons. The only thing that stopped that from being a perfect game was the fact that Robo got a turret in the top lane.
Yeah, that was... I'm going to say a clutch turret to save themselves from...